In this session, we'll discuss about the entropy function, equivocation, and mutual information topics. What do we mean by entropy? We know it is the average information that is called as entropy, which is denoted by H of S, which is equal to PI log 1 by PI. This is what already discussed in our module 1. So in that, we have the first one called as prior entropy, prior entropy. That means prior means something before. So the entropy of input symbols. What are the input symbols? A1, A2 up till AR before their transmission. It is called as the prior entropy. Prior entropy is entropy of the symbols before transmission. So entropy of the input symbols before transmission denotes the prior entropy. It is denoted by H of A because capital A is our set of input alphabets. I is 1 to R, A1, A2 up till AR are the input symbols. P of AI, probability of the input symbols. Log of, it is log to the base 2, 1 by P of AI, bits per message symbol. This is called as prior entropy, which means entropy of the input symbols A1, A2 up till AR before their transmission. Next comes the conditional entropy or posterior entropy. This is the entropy of the input symbols after transmission and reception of output symbols. Okay, so it is called as posterior entropy. So posterior means something after. So after means after the reception of the input, after the transmission of the input signals and reception of the output symbol, that is BJ. This H of AI by BJ is called as posterior entropy. That is, it is entropy of the input symbols after the transmission and reception of output symbols, BJ. So H of A by B, if I tell H of A by B, it indicates entropy of the input after its transmission and reception of output symbol B. B is what? J1, 2, 3 up till S. So BS. So now AI by BJ is given by probability of AI by BJ log 1 by P of AI by BJ. This gives you the entropy of input symbols after their transmission and reception of the output J symbols. Next is equivocation. What do we mean by the term equivocation? Average of all the conditional entropies. So we have here, this is a conditional entropy. This is a conditional entropy of the particular symbols A1, B1, A2, B1, A3, B1, or in that way. So where I is 1 to R and J is 1 to S, output symbols. But the average of all the conditional entropies gives you equivocation. Okay, average value of all conditional entropies give us equivocation. It is equivocation denoted by H of A by B, H of B by A. This is small ai by bj. It is the entropy for the input and the output symbols. But average of all these conditional entropies, average of all these conditional entropies will give you equivocation. And that is given by H of capital A by B or B by A. That means conditional entropy when B is, A is, when A1, A2, A3 up till AR transmitted, when B symbol is received, or B is received when these symbols are transmitted. So I get I is 1 to R, J is equal to 1 to S, P of AI BJ log of 1 by AI by BJ as per this A by B. Next, this is B by A. So this joint probability, this is joint probability, JP. This is JP, joint probability. And log of 1 by BJ by AI, where J is 1 to S, I is 1 to R. So the average values of all the entropies gives us equivocation. It is denoted by H of A by B or B by A. It is also called as measure of uncertainty. Yes, this is going to represent as the uncertainty. It is one term type of conditional entropy, but it is average of all the conditional entropies. Again, it is giving us conditional probability. That is probability of receiving an alphabet B1 when A1, A2, A3 are transmitted in that way. So it is a measure of uncertainty of the information that is to be received. So it is called as measure of uncertainty. That is equivocation. So we have prior entropy where it tells us the entropy of the input symbols before their transmission. It is denoted by h of a, and it is p of a log of 1 by p of a, because we know what is h of s. It is I is 1 to q, what we have discussed, average self-information, pi log 1 by pi. This was the equation we discussed in our first module, log to the base 2. So here, instead of pi, it is probability of symbol 1, 2, 3, and so on up till ar, log of 1 by p of ai. That is our entropy, prior entropy. When I go for conditional entropy or posterior entropy, it is entropy of the input symbols after the transmission and whatever the symbol has been received. That is posterior or conditional probability. It is given by h of ai by bj, which is equal to p of ai by bj, log of 1 by p of ai by bj. But average of all the conditional probabilities gives us a term called as equivocation, which indicates the measure of uncertainty. That is called as equivocation, and given these two equations, h of a by b or b by a. Next is mutual information. Mutual information is denoted by I of a comma b, where a is the input, b is the output. What is it defined as? H of a minus h of a by b, or b by b comma a is h of b minus h of b by a. So this is the entropy of the input symbols before transmission. Entropy of the symbols before transmission. This is the equivocation. This is equivocation. Correct? This is what we discussed. It's a measure of uncertainty. This term is equivocation. How do we explain this term? This is a mathematical expression. How do we talk in terms of entropy and equivocation? So when I tell an average information h of a is transmitted, we know what is entropy of any symbol. It is the average self-information. So when I tell average information h of a is transmitted over a channel, okay, how do I define mutual information? If I have average information h of a transmitted over a channel, an average amount of information equal to equivocation is lost due to noise. So h of a is transmitted over the channel. But what happens due to the noise inside the channel? Some amount of information. What is that information lost? H of a by b is lost. H of a by b is lost. Now, h of a is transmitted. H of a by b is lost. And whatever is the balance information received with respect to an observed output symbol, that is mutual information. So here, when I transmit some average information over a channel and some amount of information is lost due to the noise, so that difference of those two, whatever is at the receiver, that gives the balance information at the receiver, gives us the mutual information. So I define mutual information as h of a, which is the average information being transmitted over the channel. But at the receiver, what is received after being distorted by noise, that is the minus h of a by b. That is a measure of uncertainty. And what is the remaining balance information between after these two gives us the mutual information. The balance information received at the receiver with respect to an observed output symbol is called as mutual information. What are the properties of mutual information? Mutual information is always symmetric. I of a comma b is I of b comma a. Mutual information is always non-negative. It is always greater than or equal to zero. Now, if I want to define in terms of entropy, it is given by h of a minus h of a by b as given here. And I of b comma a is related to joint entropy. You should know what is joint entropy. H of a comma b is joint entropy, and how do I write it? P of a comma b log of 1 by p of ai comma pj. So in terms of entropy, it is this. This is the equivocation or conditional entropy. In terms of joint entropy, I write a of a comma b is equal to h of a plus h of b. See, each one is an individual entropy minus h of a comma. This is how mutual information is related. Next, coming to some of the problems related to the joint probability matrix. So, coming to the first example, transmitter has an alphabet consisting of 5 letters A1, A2, A3, A4 up to A5. Receiver has four letters, V1, V2, V3, V4. The joint probability of the system. See the joint probability matrix, JPM is given. A, comma B, it is a joint. If it is A by B, it is conditional. So we know row wise, it is A1, A2, A3, A4, A5 and common column wise, V1, V2, V3, V4. That is for the JPM matrix. So compute the entropies of the channel. So when I tell entropies of the channel, it comes H of A, H of B. Correct. And also I think we have to compute H of B, H of A comma B, H of A by B, B by A. All this have to be computed along with mutual information. So first one I have to compute H of A or H of B. So if to compute H of B, to compute H of B or H of A, H of A, what is the equation? I is 1 to R. And how many are the letters here? 5. So I is 1 to 5. P of A I log 1 by P of A. How to find the probability of the input symbols? Probability of the input symbols is determined by adding all the elements of the JPM row wise. If I add elements of the JPM row wise, okay, I get the probability of input symbols. So when I add row wise, P of A1 0.25, P of A2 0.10 plus 0.30, P of A3 0.05 plus 0.10, P of A4 0.05 plus 0.1, P of A5 0.05. So I get all the probabilities of input symbols by adding the elements row wise of a JPM matrix. That is the property of the JPM. So after that, I know what is P of A1 0.25, P of A2 0.4, P of A3 0.15, P of A4 0.15, P of A5 0.0. So I get the entropy of the input symbols H of A. This is how I find H of A. Next, from the same matrix, I have to find H of B. Adding column wise is going to give you the probability of the output symbols P of BJ. So here, when I add column wise, 0.25 plus 0.10, I get 0.35. Next, 0.30 plus 0.05, again I get 0.35. Next, I add 0.10, 0.05 plus 0.05, I get 0.2. Next, I add 0.10 plus 0, I get this. So when I get all these, P of B I have to calculate, H of B, which is P of BJ log 1 by P of BJ. J is 1 to 4 because we have 4 letters, V1, V2, V3, V4. By substituting these here, I'm getting probability entropy of the output symbols 1.857. Next, I have to calculate the joint entropy. Joint entropy is H of A comma B. And it is given by P of AI BJ log of 1 by P of AI into BJ. What is this probability? Joint probability. Joint probability is from the matrix because the given matrix itself is joint. So I have to take all these elements 0.25, 0.10, 0.30, 0.05. All these elements have to be taken. See here 0.25, 0.1, 0.3, 0.05, 0.1, 0.05, 0.05, 0.1, and respective log of that and calculated. I get H of A, B. This is the joint entropy. This is the joint entropy. I am obtaining easily because the matrix given is joint probability matrix. See here, joint probability. So I'm using these elements to find a joint entropy. After I get H of A comma B, I have to find equivocation. I know what is equivocation. We have discussed here. Equation for equivocation. It's already discussed. From this equation, H of A comma B, I can calculate what is equivocation. So here, coming back to the slides, H of B by A is H of AB, that is the joint entropy, minus H of A gives you H of B by A. Next, I want H of A by B. So this is again H of A comma B, joint entropy, minus H of B. This gives you H of A by B. Now I want mutual information. Mutual information in terms of conditional entropy. H of A minus H of A by B. So that gives you, you have A by B with you, you have H of A with us, we have calculated. That gives you mutual information, I of A comma B. So you have to find equivocation H of A by B and H of B by A. So once we have the joint entropy and individual entropies of input and output symbols, finding equivocation becomes easier. So if I want A by B, it is B minus H of B. B by A, joint entropy minus H of A. So that will give us equivocation. And if I want mutual information, H of A minus H of B by A, or A by B also can be done, H of A by B. That gives us the mutual information. I have already given the equation here for mutual information. This equation, H of A minus H of A by B, which is in terms of entropy of the channel. So using that equation, I am determining what is the mutual information.